Hi everyone, Rabbi David Tawil here from Mishna Study, Masechet Shevuot, Perek Chet, Mishna Gimel. Mishna Gimel continues to talk about situations of the Shomrim, specifically Shomer Hinam, who has the ability to take an oath and exempt himself from just about all cases. When will his oath, if made in vain, cause him to have to bring a korban for Shevuot HaPikadon? The Mishna reads several cases. The first, Hechan Shori, a person says to his Shomer Hinam, where is my ox, which I gave over to you? Amar lo, eni yodea ma'ata sach. And the Shomer Hinam responds to him, I have no idea what you're talking about. He claims total innocence, feigns that this ever even happened. Vehu, but in reality, shemet, it either died, or nishbar, it was broken, or nishba, it was captured, or nignav, it was stolen, or avad, or it was lost. Any one of the five cases, which normally a Shomer Hinam would be exempt from if he took an oath. Mashbiacha ani, and the person makes him swear to what he's saying, ve'amar amen, and he says amen, yes, patur, he's exempt. Again, even though he took a false oath, this is similar to the case in the prior Mishnah, even though he took a false oath, since any of the claims had been true, had he made any of the claims that were really true, they would also be exempt on them. Therefore, even though his shavua is invalid here, is false here, he's not going to be hayav shavua to be gadon, because it's not really costing the guy any money. He could have easily claimed the truth and also become exempt as well. Therefore, it's no shavua to be gadon. Hechan shori. If, however, the person says to a shomer hinam, where's my ox? Amar lo avad. He tells him it was lost. Mashbi acha ani, to which he makes him swear, ve'amar amen, and he takes an oath. Ve'ha'edim mi'edim oto she'achalo. And now witnesses come and testify that he, in fact, ate the object. Let's say he had him watch food or something like that, or he used it, or he borrowed it, whatever it was. He was shalach yado b'lechet re'ayhu, as we read in the Pesukim in the Torah. Then, mishalem et hakeren. Now he has to pay back the principal amount, because since witnesses testified, then he's going to have to pay back that which he took from the person. Again, there's no korban over here, because in this situation, he was not modeh on himself. The case of Shevuat HaPikadon, which he would have to bring a korban, is if he was modeh on his own. Watch as we read Bar Tinura over here on the right-hand side of the screen, if you're watching. He says, "Mashbiacha ani ve'amar amen b'ha'idim me'idim oto she'achalo mishalem et hakeren ve'lo kefil." So first thing is, he doesn't have to pay double. Now, why doesn't he have to pay double? Normally, the Torah says that a person who steals something from somebody and is caught has to pay double. Well, over here, the shomer is acting as a thief, because he's basically claiming nothing happened, when in reality, he stole the object, and now witnesses are testifying against him. You should have to pay kefil. Why doesn't he have to pay kefil? V'imhodalo me'atzmo ad shelo ba'o edim mishalem keren v'homesh ve'ashem. But if he had admitted on his own, he would not, before the edim came, then he would have to pay the principal and plus a fifth, 20%, and Hashem. And he would have to pay for a korban Hashem, a guilt offering, kedin shivu'at ha'pikadon. So in other words, in this situation, had he testified after he took a false oath, had he then come back and said, actually, I admit that I was the one who took it and I swore falsely under oath, he would have to pay back the kedin plus 20% for having stolen the object, plus an asham, plus a guilt offering for Shivu'at HaPikadon, de'enam ba'ad shemodeh v'shav minish'ato ba'lehit kapir. Because it's very important, he does not bring a korban for Shivu'at HaPikadon unless he's coming and admitting that he did the evil deed and he wishes to take an atonement. He wants to be mitkaper for what he did. So in other words, in the Mishnah, when it says that he took an oath that it was lost, and he says, yes, I take an oath, and the edim are me'edim oto she'achalon, the edim testify that he ate it, and yet he does, so he pays because the edim testified, but he's still yet to admit that he was actually guilty. He's only going to pay keren, and he's not going to pay kefil. The reason why he doesn't pay kefil was because there was a ta'anat ne'evad. There was a ta'ana of it was lost, not a ta'ana of it was stolen. The stolen ta'ana would have warranted him kefil, but here it was a ta'ana that it was lost. So since that was the ta'ana, it's not a case of thievery, and therefore he doesn't have to pay kefil. He has to pay the kedin. Why doesn't he pay the chomesh and the asham for Shevuat HaPikadon? That's because he was never modeh on his own. He's only paying because the witnesses made him pay. Hence the next line in the Mishnah, hodah me'atzmo, if he admitted on his own, mishalem kedin ve'chomesh ve'asham. Then he has to pay the principal plus a 20% penalty for Shevuat HaPikadon plus the korban asham for Shevuat HaPikadon, since he's being modeh on his own. All of that was in the case of avad. That's why kefil was not an issue. The final case of the Mishnah, Hechan Shori, the person says, where is my ox? Amar lo nignav. And here he says, oh, it was stolen. So now there was a ta'ana on the part of the shomer that it was stolen. Mashbi'acha ani, the guy makes him swear, Ve'amar amen, and he takes an oath that it was stolen. Ve'ha'edim me'edim oto she'genavo, and then the witnesses come and testify that he stole it. Mishalem tashlume kefil. Now he has to go ahead and pay tashlume kefil. Why does he have to pay tashlume kefil? As Baratirura says, he says, shomer hinam ha'poter atzmo b'ta'anat ganav v'nishba, because a shomer hinam who exempted himself with a claim of it was stolen and then took an oath, ubao edim, and then edim came, he has to pay kefil, specifically in that case. Dichtiv, as the pasuk says, imlo yimatze ha'ganav, if the thief was not found, imlo yimatze kemo she'amar, if he was not found in the way in which he said, ela shehu atzmo genavo, but he was the one who stole it, yishalem she'nayim. Then he has to pay double. But if he came to exempt himself in a claim of avad, it was lost, then he was found to have actually stolen it. That's not the same way that he had claimed it, because it wasn't nignav, it was the claim. The claim was avad. So there's a lot of technicality over here. If the shomer hinam took on a claim that it was ne'evad, then if he's found to be false and he's actually caught, he doesn't have to pay kefil, because it wasn't a claim of nignav. That's not im lo yimatze ganav. It's not following the Torah's thing that if the ganav was found in the way in which he said it was a nignav. Therefore, it can only have kefil if the shomer hinam claimed a din of an issue of geneva. And that's what happens in the sefa of the Mishnah. Once again, the sefa of the Mishnah tells us, hoda me'atzmo, if he admitted on his own without witnesses having to come after he had already taken a false oath, Mishalem keren v'honesh v'asham. Once again, he's going to have to pay the principal plus the 20% and the asham for Shivu'at Pikadon, seeing as how he's now admitting and he wants to do kapara, he wants to receive atonement for his false oath without Edim having to force him into the payment.